Dear students, let us learn about the Indian land resources today. Land use pattern of India. The meaning of it is, the land is distributed for different uses such as forestry, cultivation, pastures, etc. And this is called as land use or land utilization. Land is one of the most important natural resources of a country. Now, the land also is classified into 7 categories. The first is net area zone. What does it mean? It includes land that can be used to cultivate the crops. And this category is very important in an agricultural country like India. Second is the forest area. 22.8% of the total reported area is under forest in India. It is high in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and in the northeastern states. Third is land not available for cultivation. Land used for non-agricultural purposes like human settlements, roads, railways, canals, mountains, sandy waste, etc. come under this category. So the fourth classification is fallow land. It refers to the land which is not used for cultivation and it is largely found in Mizoram, Tamil Nadu and Meghalaya, etc. Fifth is cultivable waste land. It includes the land which is not taken up for cultivation due to certain soil deficiencies. Sixth is the permanent pastures and other grazing lands. It accounts for only 3.4% of the total reporting area in India. The seventh classification of land is land under miscellaneous uses. It includes gardens, orchards and plantations which account for only 1.1% of total area in the country. Agriculture. Tilling of soil for raising food crops and raw materials needed by human beings is called agriculture. Even it is extended to include stock raising, poultry farming and beekeeping. Importance of agriculture. India is a country known for agriculture. 65% of the people depend on agriculture. The economic progress of the country depends on the progress of agriculture. In India, the main source of livelihood is agriculture only. It is the main source of food for the people and fodder for domestic animals. It is a source of national income and revenue. Agriculture supports tertiary sectors like trade, transport, banking, insurance, etc. It also has influence on the political and social situation of the country. It supports many industries, that is cotton and jute, textiles, sugar industry, etc. This is very important, students. You should know the meaning and the importance of agriculture. All these points you have to cover in your answer. The types of agriculture are as follows. First is subsistence farming. A type of farming in which the production of crops is consumed almost by the farmer and his family, leaving only a small portion for sale. That is known as subsistence farming. This question was asked last time, students. It is of two types, shifting subsistence farming and sedentary subsistence farming. Second is intensive farming, a method of farming in which a large amount of capital and labor are applied per unit of land is called intensive farming. This was also asked. Third is commercial farming, a system of farming in which crops are grown for the market is called commercial farming. Mixed farming, agriculture involving the cultivation of crops and livestock rearing is called mixed farming. Fifth is plantation farming. It refers to the cultivation of single crop on large estates for the market. it requires more labor and capital, tea, coffee, rubber, coconut, etc. This is plantation farming. Sixth is dry farming, a method of farming carried on in areas which receives very less rainfall and where irrigation is either absent or limited is called dry farming. Seventh is humid farming. It refers to the cultivation of crops in areas which receives sufficient rainfall. And the last is irrigation farming, a method of farming under which crops are grown with the help of irrigation is called irrigation farming. Crop season, it is the proportion of area under different crops at a particular period of time is called crop season. In India, there are three cropping seasons, the Kharif, the Rabi and the Zaid crop seasons. Very important it is, students. First, the Kharif crop season, the crops grown under the rainy season are called Kharif crops. The sowing takes place in June to July when the southwest monsoon starts and crops are harvested in September. Second is the Rabi crop season. The sowing takes place in October, November when the northeast monsoon begins and are harvested in February to March. Zaid crop season are grown in between the Kharif and the Rabi crops are known as Zaid crops. They are watermelon, cucumber, oil seeds and some pulses, vegetables, etc. Cropping pattern, it is important. The cropping pattern of a region refers to the proportion of an area under different crops at a given time. The cropping pattern of any region in India changes from time to time. Role of horticulture and floriculture. Horticulture, the intensive cultivation of fruits, vegetables, flowers, medicinal and aromatic plants is called horticulture. It enhances exports and provides nutritional security. India, with its wide variety of climate and soil, has good potential for growing a variety of horticulture crops. Floriculture, it is the cultivation of flowers for commercial purpose. India is known for the art of growing flowers since time immemorial. It plays a significant role in Indian culture. India's agroclimatic conditions are very suitable for the cultivation of variety of flowers. So climate is very important here, and India has a very good climate. India is known for growing traditional flowers such as jasmine, marigold, rose, etc. Floriculture is mainly developed in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, etc. This is all about the lesson, children.